thanks, dude, for making me come with exiles. I appreciate you.
Woo! It's time. You know, we just had an amazing set, and during the set, I was like, you guys know it's not even done. We still have Latif behind this. Latif versus Uriel Legion, you know, first to seven. Latif is on a 3 win streak in a row. Let us see if he can get a 4th win over Uriel Legion. Uriel is definitely ready to play.
Oh, yeah. He's been training. Obviously, he streams a lot as well. He's been preparing. But this is Swole Teeth. Swole Teeth, bruv. His Zato is actually insane. And when we're talking about these players being good, there was no region lock to it. We weren't saying they're like the best in EU or anything like that. They're just some of the best players with their main characters.
Absolutely. And I forgot to tweet about the main card. I need to do this, guys. We hit the 500 today. Let's try to hit the 600s. That's what we want. Guilty Gear Strive hype every single Friday on this stream. Plenty of qualifiers, including like C4's qualifier on Wednesdays. Let's go. The opening goes to Zato Ichi.
It does indeed. We've got Uriel going for the burst. The cake maintains some momentum. He's got it. The corner lockdown. The sword is swinging. Sham Show mode activated. Can Latif get out? He does.
Alright, let's go. Latif putting the work in the corner. He's just going to get for the wall splat, for the wall break, and that Eddie Gage is down. But you know what? We open with the super, and that is gonna eat your 5k like nothing. It's snack time.
Munching. Put those Yeezys down. They're not my size. Put the trainers away. I'm not interested. Hit me the shark. And now again, Latif with the momentum, getting in the corner. Eddie's out. But oh, pose is so grimy. Super smart, going for executioner to give Eddie meter back as we go down in the canyon, fully stopped. What is Uriel gonna do?
It's looking difficult for a start. There is a super available. That's not gonna kill, I believe, no. But good situation for Latif. There is a burst on Uriel's side. Latif keeping some damage from a distance. You're forced to FD right now, straight to the burst. That is smart, but lots of work for Uriel right now. That blood gauge is getting full. He's gonna need that command grab. What?
Yes. This is what you're going to know about some old school players. Damascus and everyone in chat. If you don't know, the best anti-air in Guilty Gear has always been air throw. I kid you not. That's why you know he's old guard. Swole Teeth is old guard.
Press one anti-air if with air throws. Hit.
No jokes.
Me estoy muriendo. This is all I can say. It's looking kind of ridiculous. Kind of ridiculous, guys. Let's go. Latif, 1. Uriel Legion, 0. Shoutouts to SSF for the extra 20. We are at $92 for the winner of today's Wanted. You know this set is about to be a banger. 1-0 for Latif.
Big up, SSF. One of the sickest shits we got. Right. Standard Eddie pressure. Here we go. Execution. I'll put the sword out. But nice jump out by Uriel. And he can get the party started. Not having to worry about Eddie for a hot minute. The backdash by... And that's by Swole Teeth. But he's still going to get put in the corner here. Damascus. I think Uriel's woken up.
Yeah, this is good for Uriel right now. There's no burst on Latif's side. But the round start, I won't say. The screen start is in Latif's favor. Uriel in the corner. Uses the yellow RC. Good backdash by Latif. There is a burst. You can't really burst that just yet. And look at Latif keeping that social distancing. Any burst will do nothing. Block, fam. You can't block that.
Death by Sharknado, Damascus. Hate to see it. And he's brought it out. And we saw it in all the other sets. The command grab, normally backed by a pose, is obnoxious to deal with.
My god, it's looking long already, but let's see. Uriel trying to chase, but Latif is playing a bit too good right now. Latif with a dash in. Oop, that's gonna be whiff punished. Can't do much more, but still, we're blocking in the corner. Uriel, you're forced to be there, waiting, and you cannot block that throw. How much damage you get? God damn, man.
I mean, luckily enough, you know, Nago's got good defense. Oh, showing the Yeezys. But the 5-piece from Swole Teeth taking that second game. Yeah, I feel Uriel's just not getting anything started. I mean, The spacing and the movement by Latif is just a bit too much right now. Maybe, hopefully, something like the new buff to the clone, that might help. I don't know how it interacts with Eddie, though, because getting rid of Eddie on the screen is super important in most matchups against Zato. Getting rid of Eddie is critical.
Yeah.
And Nago with the slow mobility, kind of like a big body, right? He's got the big normals, but can he swipe Eddie? That's the thing. He needs to find him on Tinder. give him that good swap, let him know he's ready to link up.
See, ridiculous. Shout out to Vindictive as well for the extra 10. God damn, ridiculous. Someone's gonna fill his fridge today, and that's what we want, guys. The champions, the players, they give us so much entertainment every single week. Shout out to all of you guys, as always, for pulling up. You guys are ridiculous, and Latif, so is Latif. As look at this, defending properly, putting some pressure. Uriel sitting on his burst, but right in the corner. And look at the blood gauge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a checkmate situation for Nago in most situations, especially when you're back to the corner and you've got Eddie putting all this pressure on. Your options are limited, right? Because you want to keep the mask on.
Yeah. Just waiting right now. Yeah, he's trying to whiff a bit, but that's also another thing. You're not going to whiff against Latif when Latif has a super ready as well. You know that full screen. You know what's happening. He did so much last week against Kurokic. Latif keeping the pressure? No, we're back to full screen.
Yeah, the 6P for the jump in. 2S, serve him up, and that should be enough, right? Yeah, it is. Zato, one of the characters that kind of goes on the radar when it comes to damage, but he can definitely dish out.
Oh, definitely. Given the right times, I mean, Latif has been posting TODs with his Zato lately on Twitter.
It's not okay, man. When Kermit the Frog's in the combo, you're definitely looking at about 50%.
Whew. All right. Latif, listen, Sifo, I must say something. Like, we'll see. Like, so far, this is how the set goes. But watching Latif lately made me feel like Latif is actually the next level. You know how last week there was a tournament in Spain with all of the best players in Europe?
Yes, in the Coliseum,
And Skill won that tournament by beating, like, pretty much everyone, like, being ridiculous. Do you guys know what was the score between Latif and Skill in the first 2-7?
I remember. Vividly. Yeah.
It was 7-0.
He got a sponge bath, bro. After he gave me one, to be fair.
It was...
Yeah, that was...
Latif's weakness is that he's too strong. Weak point, too strong. I'm too good, man. That's like, come on,
and he
man.
He knows it. He knows as well. If you see him stream, he will tell you how good he is. He's not bashful about it.
We got this meme in French saying "point faible, trop fort," which literally means this: like weakness, too strong. That's the only weakness we could we could pinpoint on this guy. You know?
There is no chinks in his armor right now. Let's be cool. We have to call Slash. That's the only person that can kind of like trigger Latif right
well,
now.
Well, Slash was supposed to come this week because Slash record was 3, which equals Latif, but Slash has exams this week. So he was like, okay. I'm working on exams, I'll come back. So I think he should be there next week. But, you know, we definitely want it to happen. At the moment, Latif has to defend, of course, his crown and get his money in the pocket. What a round, man. Yes, yeah, it is same Latif who sweeped through SF4 with Sea Viper. It is him.
The one and only. It looks a lot different. But it's the same guy, same guy. Insane execution. Right now, Sharknado, though, going to get the Eddie meter back to blue so we can start the sequence all over again. Run the script. Uriel, can you get out? He does get out, Damascus.
He does. Massively. Massive moment for Uriel. But look at this. Latif keeps the pressure. I feel like Uriel has not been able to take a break from the beginning of that set.
Nope. Latif's non-Eddie pressure is, I think, what puts him apart from other Zetas. He can actually...
Oh my god. C4! Not like this! Not like... No! Not like this! Clip the hell out of that!
Cut. Time out. He broke the law in the Damascus, bruv. Call the police. He literally did tap break the law. So the burst whiff came up, scooped him in the Sharknado. This is Latif, bruv. Day in, day out, he be like this. He definitely just do be like this.
This is long, man. This is extremely long.
Wait.
4-0. And not over. And again, right? That guy is 7-0 skill last time. He's 7-1 Zando. Zando who was like running a train on everyone unwanted. Right? Yep. And now he's there, putting more pressure on Uriel Legion of all people.
It's a madness. And he said it from day one, right? People are going to get swept off their feet. Uriel, it's not over yet, my guy.
It's not. Oh my god. Hey.
Yeah, sick.
Esports. Los Deportes Electronicos. Okay?
The funny thing is, the T's been in that same situation in tournament against Slash. And what happens is you gain bar. You keep gaining tension. But then you get a negative penalty. So Uriel, smartly enough, went, I'm going to lick off a super as soon as I can get it. Let him know. I'm not playing this silly dance with a two-piece of stuff. Good stuff.
Esports, man. Esports. Los Deportes Electronicos. This is what we do here. What we do on Monty every week. Shout out to all of the new guys, huh? Much love to everyone on the chat. We're getting close to 600. Maybe we'll break the record today. But at the moment, it's Latif blocking, trying to put some pressure. Uriel escaping. There's a ton of bar on Latif's side. Uriel, what can you do? You don't even have much bar to FD. Back throw.
Nice back throw. Ooh, the frame.
Oh my.
Eat your soul. Soul return, Damascus. Give it back to me. Soul Reavers, not anymore. Give me my soul back. We can all bait burst. You're not special, Latif. Let him know, Uriel. Let him know.
That was needed. And gaining his first point through that strong of a read was absolutely needed. Yeah. Uriel finally builds some momentum against Latif. But goddamn, it feels like he's got to be like 1,000%.
Yeah.
On point.
TN third eye open, bro. Like all kinds of woke. All kinds of work. Like he got really good reads on the back dashes, and I think that's what allowed him to get to turn the momentum around. Because Latif, unlike a lot of other Zatos, doesn't go for the sandwich stuff, right? A lot of other Latifs are trying to get you between Eddie and Zato. Latif is just happy to get you in the corner. He'll use Eddie to put you in the corner. He'll do a sequence without Eddie, and then he will just run the script. And we might see it now.
All right, that's a strong start though. Hi, Latif, running in, putting him in the corner. Good block on the dust. He backdashed to dust. Unfortunately, the conversion was not there, but that was sick defense by Uriel. Uriel is going to get his zone combo side switch as well. La Salsita is applied on the opponent, but watch out for the blood gauge because we're in level 3.
Nice poke with the 2S. Didn't get too much off it. And there we go. Finally seeing the clone come into play. Does get rid of Eddie as well, but then Latif just backs away. Go. He knows his lane. He's staying in it and he knows how to win.
Oh, I thought that would convert.
Yeah,
I was about to say, what a conversion, man. I was already praising Latif for this.
And then he surfs in to mid-range, came with a 6P. He's got all the bases covered, it seems, man. This is an opponent and a half to fight against. This is number one headband status.
It is. He's playing with an assist. This is what he does. He's in the wrong game. My man is there playing tag team in a 1v1 game. And look at this, trying to walk a bit, and it's time for the sandwich. That was not a good burst, and Latif is gonna put him into the corner. There is bar on Latif's side. Uriel struggling. The shield is up there. Latif with the super, and it's a one touchy.
And here we go again. The best of friendos. Eddie's nice. Out. That was smart.
That
and
was really smart.
Latif just evaluated all of that. Oh no. Ooh. It was a sticky situation. Yeah. It's looking long. And that's the worst thing, right? When you play someone who's strong, and I think this goes for most long games with burst, but mostly Gui gear. When you get hit, right? Uriel used the bar really smart to get in on Latif. Yeah. And then Latif went burst.
Yeah.
You're not going to bait it now because you're so hungry to get in.
Yeah. He spent the last 30 seconds far, right? So, like, you know, like, come with the idea of immediately baiting. And he didn't have the meter for it anyway after like a Beyblade, so that was like difficult. 5-1 for Latif, once again, a statement from the champion. And he opens with the classic drop, but that's gonna be more pressure from Latif.
Alright. Kermit the Frog, ribbit, break the wall. Look at the damage already, man. Different. Latif is just different.
Oof. Mixed. One touch. Ooh. One touchy. He blocks. Oh my! Yeah, you can't. You can't block. You can't block all day, man. You cannot block all day. Latif still looking good.
Yeah, straight dominance that round. Just showcasing the character. Uriel looking like a training dummy right now. We know he's better than this, but what do you do against this obliterating offense with two characters? The Eddie Zato combination is too strong.
It's actually too strong, and we've seen Uriel trying to get the clone through Eddie as well, but it's just not working. The oppos were coming out. The Sharknado is there, guys. Don't tell me this is happening.
Possible's out already. Maybe. I don't want Uriel to go to Brazil. I don't want him to go there.
Do you need a visa if you travel from Spain to Brazil? Uriel, is your passport still valid? Because at the moment, I can't lie. It's looking long. 6-1 for Latif. Uriel needs to win 6 games in a row.
Alright, let's go, Uriel. Get one more on the boards. You don't have to go to a coffin. You don't have to go to Brazil. You can go back to training mode. That's what we want for you. Oh, the oppose as well, keeping Zato safe. Clapping his hands. Breaks the wall. Down in the canyon. Good counter poke in the 2S. But what can he get from it?
Oh my god,
subways.
Yeah, subways. The sandwiches are always ready. He wanted to slow time down, but not gonna happen. Latif, what the hell was this, man?
Damn, almost a kill combo. That's almost what it was. Luckily, again, Nago with a good defense, but look at this. Okay, he's in. And Latif is so not afraid to press buttons because he knows all the pressure is on Uriel's side. Uriel has to make the big reads. Latif is 6 games up. He can just press buttons whenever he wants.
Yeah. Yep, let's see. Dashing in, all right. The pressure is on. Uriel putting the pressure, but no, the burst. And Uriel is not baiting burst anymore right now. All he wants is damage, but it's not just gonna work. Look at this. Latif reclaims the corner. Look at that damage on this. Mixes. Schmixterization. We're getting the back throw. We're getting the throw again. Latif, stop.
Stop. Statements. Stop. Bro, come sign the contract. He's trying to get statements out of people, bro. No snitching, Uriel, please. Bye.
Okay. Uriel, you only need one opening, but you won't get it. And it's time to stamp the visa. Brazil.